great pleasure to welcome back to Larry King Live Michael Hingson and his amazing guide dog, Roselle. Michael was working in the World Trade Center at the time of 9/11 attack. He is blind. Roselle helped guide him down 78 floors to safety. He's given keynote speech at Rutgers for the Conference on Strategies for the Future. And Roselle has been honored with a congressional record insert saluting her inspirational story. And Roselle is receiving the American Kennel Club's 2002 ACE Award as Service Dog of the Year, a big doggy deal. And Roselle deserves it all. How you doing, Michael?
Doing well. How are you?
How do you feel on this anniversary?
Sad. It's been a year of change. It's certainly been a year of tough things. And it's been a year of joys also.
What was your job in the World Trade Center?
I worked for Quantum Storage Solutions Group. I managed the New York, New Jersey office.
And how can you do that? Was that difficult to do without sight?
No. It was no different, I think, for me than anyone else. I used different tools, but still did the same job. Excuse me. I managed the sales force. Went on lots of sales calls. New York's a great place to do that. New Jersey works well for that. So I had no problems.
And now, though, you're a Californian, huh?
Changed careers. Partly probably because of you. Just a lot of attention, people wanting to connect to 9/11, wanted to hear our story. And I was asked to join Guide Dogs for the Blind in San Rafael, where Roselle is from. And I chose to do that as kind of a way, in part, to give back to guide dogs. I've been getting dogs from guide dogs for 38 years, and so this was a way to kind of help. So when I go and give speeches, all the proceeds of those go directly to Guide Dogs for the Blind.
Can you briefly explain on 9/11 what you can't see? What did you hear? What happened?
When the airplane first struck the tower, I felt as much as heard a thud, just a big explosion, and then the building tilted. It came upright. Our guests, who we had in the office at the time, were screaming and running toward the exit. I was in my office with a colleague, David Frank. David was the first to identify that there was fire above us. I heard debris falling. We got our guests out. I was concerned that I wasn't going to leave until they were gone. David got them headed toward the stairs. I had attended lots of fire drills, so I knew not to take elevators, told him to make sure they took the stairs. And as soon as they were gone, then we left. I had called my wife while David was getting them out to tell her that something happened, and then we left.
And you left how? Were you panicky?
No, I couldn't afford to, very consciously. I also had a calming sense from God. I asked God what to do and just had a feeling to stay calm, and so I did. And so I took Roselle's harness and gave her the appropriate commands, such as to go forward, to go left and right and so on, to get where we needed to go. It was my responsibility to know how to get to the stairs and her job to make sure that we walked safely.
And once you were on the stairs, you're hearing people all around you?
A lot of people around
screaming.
Us. Screaming? Not too much. It was tense, but people were calm. We had some burn victims pass us, but it was calm.
And you just followed him down the stairs, followed her down the stairs.
Right. We worked together, and I know that we helped others go down the stairs, and Roselle had a chance to flirt with some of the firemen as we were going down the stairs, because as they came up, they would ask me if I were okay. Roselle gave lots of kisses, and I know that some of them petted Roselle.
So is she always this calm?
When she's in harness, she does a good job. I asked Guide Dogs for a dog that would focus, and they did a good job of giving me one.
What happened when you got to the ground?
We went to a parking lot across from Two World Trade Center, but before we got there, the building collapsed, so we literally turned and ran for our lives and ran into a subway station to avoid some of the dust cloud. By that time, we had inhaled a lot.
How did you not run into things?
Roselle. Strictly following Roselle. Again, I told Roselle to go forward. When we got to the end of a building, I could hear that we were at the end of the building. I knew that we were at a street corner. I told her to go right because that was away from the Trade Center. She turned and we went, and there were a lot of people running with us and around us. So it was kind of a crowd mentality.
Were you born blind?
Yes.
So you've never had sight?
No.
At any time during all of this, were you frightened?
Two times. Once when the building was hit, the other time when the tower was coming down. And I recall the second time saying to God, how do you do this? You got us out of this building just for another one to collapse on us. And I, again, was just overwhelmed with a sense of calm and a sense of don't worry about what you can't control. And that's one of the things that I talk about in a lot of my speeches, the concept of trust and reminding people, don't worry about what you can't control, worry about what you can.
Boy, you are certainly an inspiration. And how have you dealt with now your fame?
Oh, I don't know about a lot of...
People know you now. A lot of people must come up to you.
They do, and they come up and talk to Roselle, and I hear people shouting at Roselle from across the street, and we talk back and do what we can to help people connect around the country to what has happened and move forward, because we've got to go forward to something, and I have found that everyone who is making progress and able to cope with it is going forward. They've got a goal or a project to go toward, and most of all of us are adopting the position, don't let the bad guys win, and that's one of the things that I talk about.
We salute you, Michael. We congratulate you, Roselle, on being the Ace of Water Service Dog of the Year. Michael Hingson and his guide dog, Roselle, worked their way down from floor 78, the World Trade Center, 1 year ago today. We're going to take a break. As we go to break, here's another shot of Ground Zero tonight. By the way, a beautiful night in Manhattan. Humidity is gone and a lot of wind today. That's cleared off. Just a beautiful fall evening, as it was a beautiful day a year ago.